For this one-on-one session, as I told you, I would now like to invite on stage Mr. Sai Nagesh. He is the Chief Strategy Officer of Lakshya Media Group. Please give a big round of applause to him and welcome him.
Hello.
Hi. Can you all hear me? Good evening, and I know it's not seeming a good evening for you all. I also know I have a very dangerous job, engaging with the speaker after the last session and keeping you away from the bar. I promise on my heart I'll not take more than a couple of minutes. Okay. So, thanks, Shankar. That was very interesting. Okay. I had some thoughts which got further enhanced after hearing you out. While most marketers in this country have been about changing brand choices and switching from one product to another, you as a company have been on the forefront of creating something new altogether. So while doing that during the entire journey of building Paytm, what's been the single biggest learning and how did you apply it to your business?
Okay, I think the single biggest learning for me and for our organization has been that you need to define your competition set in a very, very broad way. And I'll illustrate that with an example. So basically, ours is an app-based business, right? And we can very conveniently tell ourselves that if I'm doing a lot of mobile recharges, then there are one or two companies I'm fighting with. Then if I'm doing online shopping, then there are the big daddies of Amazon and Flipkart and so on and so forth. Now it's very easy to take that view and only focus on those one or two different industries that you are kind of working on. But the real fact of the matter is that if you are an app, at the most the consumer is going to have 15 or 20 apps in his phone. So your competition set is not these two or three guys who are in your industry, but you are fighting against a whole plethora of apps which may be there. Against those, you have to be in the top 10, because otherwise, chances are that the person will just kind of install, but immediately one day later, uninstall you. Now, it's a very expensive battle that way, because there's a lot of cost behind getting an installation done. Right. And if that happens, then you're gone. So essentially, what we realized is, to be relevant in the day-to-day life of a person, you need to have multiple use cases. And because only then, if I need to come back to you once a day, is when I would kind of keep you in my phone, because, okay, phones have improved a little bit now, but till about a year back, I just didn't have space for more than 15 apps.
Yeah.
So I was very data conscious, because if I won't need to install an app, how big is the app? That's the question. So there are a lot of things that you need to consider, and don't have a very straight jacketed view of who your competition is, because you are fighting against a much, much wider universe.
No, that's very nice. Yeah. So with that 95% app uninstall rate, right? That's the current rate in the industry for the apps.
I wouldn't know the industry rate too well, but what happens is that, at least for us, the basis has become wider over a period of time. Every day, if I'm getting 100 apps installed, with all the uninstallations that go on, because that's a historically accumulated base, maybe I add only 20 new people.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of people from behind over the last 3-4 years who still uninstall. But I think is still healthy. There are situations where you may have a net uninstall your net installation rate may be negative.
Okay.
Because more people are removing you than new people coming on board.
Again. Yeah.
And I think it's a function of how many use cases you have.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, one of the biggest challenges being faced with the marketeers is the moving away from traditional media by consumers, and also their embracing of new forms of media which have got no ads, whether it's Netflix or Amazon Prime, etc. And also it's been reported that 33% of the reason why Netflix is being seen in this country is that there are no ads in it. And India is witness to a very high ad avoidance rate. And it's said that Indian marketers have gone over-jealous in trying to over-engage with the customer,
right,
and hence not seeing the law of diminishing return and just spending money blindly
right
on advertising.
Right.
You yourself have been a heavy advertiser, right? How have you drawn the line, a thin line between over-engaging, or do you think that word exists at all?
No, it definitely exists, because you can sometimes, there are two mistakes that you can make. One is the same communication, which is maybe not very relevant for your users, you keep pushing it down the throat, and beyond the point, it just gets irritating. And I see a lot of that in social media in India, because I think the social channel for engagement is when you have nice stories, when you have good either humor or some amount of emotion, which can, and there are certain such instances we see on social. Some campaigns go viral, but you see so many brands which are just pushing content on social about a sale which is going on, or about, you know, all these e-commerce sites are bombarding you with sale news. Beyond the point, I just don't care. It's irritating. I mean, if you have apps, the notifications that keep coming all the time, right? Yeah. It's blanket. I mean, it's just carpet bombing.
Yeah.
I mean, I get from certain apps, 7-8, I'm not talking about news apps, but otherwise there's 7-8 notifications that come, and after a while I get so irritated that I uninstall.
Yeah.
So if you use some amount of intelligence and target the user in a slightly better way, that there is a better probability of me taking an action, it's okay. But just carpet bombing me with 15 messages in a day is just over engagement. It's useless, it's irritating, and I will uninstall you. On the other hand, on TV we see what is happening, of course, is that ads are playing, a Hindi movie may be playing, and then there is 5 minutes of ads in between, and obviously no one is watching. So is that ad and waste? I think so, completely. The only way to maybe counter that is, and you see that in the rates that are being quoted, is sports is becoming very important. Because that's sports and news, of course, to an extent, is that's the only real-time content you have.
Okay.
Right? Because that guy, I mean, you may have a cricket match and a T20 match, may you have at the most 45 seconds, 60 seconds between two overs, right?
Yeah.
The person won't go anywhere. So that, I think, has become important. Sports, and I think that is perhaps one of the reasons behind Disney trying to take, buying Star.
The Star business, yeah. Okay. I had a couple of questions, but you have already answered them in your talk. One last question I had, sir, is, with increasing complexity of technology, more and more listening devices, customers getting more and more used to various things, will consumer understanding get more complex for marketers?
Yeah, of course, I definitely think so. But because there's so much data also that's being generated, right, across. But I think on the digital side, what's happening is that there is a significant digital footprint that people are leaving behind. And of course, in the last 2-3 months, you've seen all that's gone on with Facebook, and people have, because still, I think 2 months back, India frankly didn't care. I mean, we as people, we would think that, you know, my data is being used by someone, I don't really care, but there was not too much of a premium to it, right? And people could have misused it in whatever form and manner. But I think going forward, in the next, there will be a lot of regulation which will come in terms of how you can use that digital footprint and that which is being left behind. So once that goes away, or that becomes more restricted, your understanding of the user might reduce. Because till now, it was a free-for-all. I mean, on an Android phone today, I can know everything that you do, right? Because you would have put an app would have taken your SMS permission. Moment he has taken your SMS permission to read your SMS, right? To read your SMS. And the moment that happens, everything that has come to you is very, very easily readable. There are apps which are taking access to your phone, to the voice, that it's recording everything that you are doing. So, but those measures will go away. I think the market will mature. The user will obviously get fragmented across media. So where exactly do you catch him?
Yeah.
Is going to become a very, very big problem. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much.